What's up everyone, April here, happy to be back with you with another Power Platform video. Now I'm actually recording this on Tuesday, March 8th, which happens to be National Women's Day. So I wanna give a big shout out to all of my other women in tech YouTubers out there. You're doing great work and shout out to you. In this video, I wanted to talk about Power Apps printing. Now this is something that I've talked about a few times here on my channel. I've talked about how we can print from Power Apps using a Power Automate approach, and also how we can do that using a Power Apps component framework control. The Power Apps component framework approach video has been getting quite a few comments lately, and I wanted to address that because one of the good things about technology is that it's constantly changing and evolving. And since I released that video, we have some new functionality added into Power Apps that actually lets us do that same functionality natively inside of Power Apps. So my goal with this video is to walk you through this new native Power Apps printing functionality, talk about its strengths and weaknesses, and also address where you might want to use this native printing versus, say, still the Power Automate approach. So I'll break it all down right after this. Let's take a look at how we can use this new printing capability that's baked into our Canvas apps, Power Apps. I have the Power Apps editor open and I have my timesheet management app pulled up. And if I run this application, a use case where I might want to print is maybe where I see my timesheet. So I can go into an individual timesheet like this one here, and I can see a history of my time. So maybe my company is a little old school and still requires me to print out my time, or maybe I just want to keep a physical record of that. Who knows? Could be multiple reasons why we still print things these days. Well, to do this, we can use a new function built inside of PowerFX called print. So you might have noticed I have a print icon. So this is one of the other things. If you haven't explored the out-of-the-box icons lately in Power Apps, you might take another look because we have a few new ones in there. So if I go to Insert and Icons, we can scroll through and see several new icons. And one of these icons is this printer icon. So I've added that onto my screen. Now to use a print function, it doesn't matter what we're using to kick it off. It could be an icon, could be a label, a button, whatever you want for your use case. But the important part is we need to initiate the print. Now to print with this new function, all we have to do is on the object, which we want to use to initiate the printing, we need to go to its onSelect, which you see I've did here. I have the onSelect selected for this icon in the properties pane. And all we have to do is use the new function called print. So it's just print in open and close parentheses. So it doesn't accept any input parameters into it. It's just the function print. And what this does is how it functions is it literally just opens up the print screen. So it's basically the equivalent of you hitting the print screen button on your keyboard, except we can have that baked into our Canvas apps now. You see how easy that was to get started. So now if I run the application like I'm using it and I press my print button, here's that print screen that pops up. So it takes everything that you're seeing on the canvas of my Power App and it surfaces it up in this ready to print view. Now, one thing I wanted to point out that you'll notice here is the styles aren't quite matching up with what I have in my app. So if you really want it to match up, there's a hidden setting that we need to enable. So here on the print screen, we need to expand out the more settings option and click the checkbox for background graphics. And you see, as soon as we do that, now it's taking in the styles from our app. Otherwise, it will ignore all of our Power Apps custom styles that we've applied. And I personally haven't found a way where we can go and automatically default that setting to allow background graphics in the print settings. There might be a way with like a group policy or something or some kind of script, I don't know. But if you found a way to do that, drop a comment in the video and let me know so we can share that with everyone. So we do have to enable that if we want the custom colors and all that that we have in our Power App to show up. But once we do that, as we can see, we can print to a printer, or the other great thing about this is since it uses just the native printing capability, we can change this printer option in the dropdown to save as a PDF. So alternatively, if you're wanting to use this as a way to create a PDF of the data from your Power App, we can use this approach for that. So we can just do the save as PDF option, click save, and that will save that to my desktop as a PDF. So we'll call this timesheet March. And now if I open that up, there is my PDF of the timesheet. Now, another thing that you might notice here though, is if we look at the PDF that was outputted for us, we can still see our print icon, and we can see this close button, and we can see these trash can icons, which really have no need to be surfaced up in the printed or PDF version that we have here. That's just specific to the use of the app. So ideally, we would hide these from the view that is printed. So let's take a look at how we do that. To hide certain objects from our print view, we're going to need to use a particular formula. And I'm going to show you first where I found this formula. So on our Canvas app, if we click New Screen and scroll down, you should see two options here for Portrait Print and Landscape Print. So these are actually built-in screen templates that have the printing mechanism built into it. Now we don't have to use these to print. We can do what you see that I did. I took an existing app and I just put in an icon and use the print function. So we don't have to use these, but we want to copy some code from this print screen here. So if I go and just add a blank print screen, you see that the only thing that it has on it is this label that says print. But what we want to do is we want to look at this label's visible property, because we'll see a formula that we're going to want to use if we're going to mimic this functionality in other screens. So what it's doing is we can simply use the not function and we can pass into that parent.printing. So on our parent object now, if we do a dot, we see we have all these options like image position, name, orientation, size, width, but we also have a new option for printing. So it's able to check the state of the parent to tell if it's currently in a printing state. So that's what we want to key off of in our visible property. So if it's not printing, then the visibility should be true, but if it is printing, then the visibility should be false. So again, we can just copy this formula and we don't really have any use for the screen. So I'm going to remove it and we'll go back here into our time card and our print button. And on its visible property, we'll paste in that formula. And we're going to do the same for this X icon and the trash can. Now you'll notice when I paste that into the trash can icon, I'm actually getting an error. So let's troubleshoot why we might get this error. If we look where this trash can icon is located, you'll see it's within a gallery in my screen. So if we're using this formula, parent.printing, well, the parent of this icon is actually going to be the gallery. Now the galleries itself don't have a printing property that we can key off of. It's the screen that does. So in that case, if you're trying to do this in nested objects like that, we'll need to modify this formula. So instead of using parent, we'll point to the screen that the object is on. So time card continue is the name of the screen. And then we'll do a dot and we can get its printing object. So quick tip if you run into that error when you're trying to set the visibility there. Now another thing you might want to do other than just showing or hiding objects from your print view is you might want to change the styling. A good example of this could be the drop-down controls. We might not want to show the actual drop-down in the print view. Now I have two options here. I can either manipulate each of the styles that kind of make up this drop-down control, or I could add in a separate object, which is a label that will have the data stored in the drop-down in it, but the label will only show if we're printing, and otherwise when we're using the application, the drop-down will show. To me, that's gonna be the easier approach if you're worried about how the styling of, say, your drop-downs and complex field types will be displayed in your print view, is to just add labels that surface up that data, which are only shown when you're in your print view. Because having to manipulate a bunch of styles is just kind of a pain in the butt. So just to demonstrate how this would work, I'm going to go insert and add a label into here, and I'll position that kind of roughly about where my drop-down is. And to set the text that should display on this, I'm just going to set it to the same thing that the drop-down is set to, which is this item dot built to. And because the drop-down is an object which contains multiple properties, and this is just a label, I need to go one extra layer, so I need to do a dot, and we'll get the value of the item. So now I see the text there, so all I have to do is go to the label's visible property. And what we're going to do here is, again, this is within the gallery, so it's a nested object, so we need to point it directly to the screen. So we're going to go time card continue dot printing. Now notice I'm not doing the not here, because if it is printing, I do want the label to show, otherwise the label should be hidden. But I want the opposite to happen with my dropdown. So last thing I need to do is go to its visible property and we'll say not, time card continue, the name of our screen, dot printing. So now that we have this all configured, let's just run through it one more time. We'll click our print button. And now you see from the print preview that shows here, all of my icons are gone and that dropdown object is also cleaned up where it just shows the text. Now I mentioned I was going to talk about the pros and cons. So what are the gotchas with this new print functionality? Because it looks pretty cool, right? Very simple to use and get started with it. Now the main gotcha here is how it's designed. This is like I said, just a print screen functionality brought into Power Apps. So what that means is, if I were to go here and add more time card records, so I'm going to keep hitting the plus to the point to where I have some scrolling going on. So all this can't fit on the screen. What happens if I use the native print functionality to print this? So if I click it, you see it's going to get cut off. It's only going to print what's in the context and visible in the screen. So in this case where you might have more data than what fits on a screen, you have scrolling going on in your app, that's when you want to move on to a different solution. So that could either be a PCF, Power Apps Component Framework control that allows you to print, such as the one that Yash Agarwal built and I made a video about, which again, I'll have a link to in the video description so that you can reference that, or using alternatively the Power Automate approach. So really what you need to consider when choosing an alternative if the out of the box doesn't work for your needs is your comfort level with editing PCF controls and your desired user experience. So if you have someone that can edit a PCF control to change the stylings for you on your team, or if you can do that yourself, then that would probably be the next best experience because it would be built into the Canvas app experience to pop open the option to print it. Now, if that doesn't work for you for any reason, that's when I would turn to the Power Automate approach, which involves converting the objects that you want to print in Power Apps to HTML using an HTML control like you're seeing here, and then passing that into a flow. And the flow would essentially take the HTML that you pass from your Power Apps trigger. It would store that in a variable. It would utilize the OneDrive connector to create an HTML file based off of that data. It would utilize the OneDrive connector again to convert that HTML to a PDF. And optionally, you could upload that to another file storage space, like say maybe a SharePoint library, and pass that file back to your Power App so that someone could click the link and then print the PDF. So that's how I would look at it when you're trying to figure out the best mechanism to add printing into your Power Apps applications. Now, this printing functionality has been out for a little while now. I just haven't got around to making a video on it, but since I was getting so many comments on some of my other printing videos, I thought it was time to get to it, and better late than never. So hopefully, if you didn't already know about the printing functionality, this is a good introduction on how to get started. Thank you so much for watching. If you want to learn more about printing and the other options out there, be sure to check out one of these other videos that I offer. And if you enjoyed this video, please do me a favor and hit that thumbs up button, subscribe, and share it with your friends. Thanks so much, and I'll catch you in the next video.